video, I'm going to talk to you guys about militia physical standards, because I believe there should be standards. So, I don't believe that people should be able to participate in an organized militia if they are ones that basically exemplify the donut curl or the couch curl, I guess you could say, where they curl up on the couch and that's basically all they ever do. And they just YouTube their way to success. So, anyways, I've broken this up as far as discussing physical standards, as you can see. So I've got body groups, the qualities that they should possess, and the functions that they're going to have to be able to perform. And I know that some people are like, well, we're not the military, we're not going to be doing all this, we got day jobs and all that crap. You know, there's plenty of people that are in militia that will still find time to go to the gym, yet their ability to function is piss poor. So they still can't handle their weapon in an isometric format, even though they can curl, you know, their own body weight, or they can bench press four times their body. It doesn't matter. It doesn't mean that you can hold an isometric position for a good amount of time while you're engaging a target and paying attention to things around you. There's just some functional things. Most of the functional things when it comes to fighting cannot be done in the gym or through your generic workout, so that's the point of this. Part of the point of this. So, first thing is body groups. So, you have arms, goes from the wrists to the shoulders. You have the torso, which is from the neck to the hips. And then you have the legs, which is your wheels. So, it goes from the hips to your feet. So, each one of these areas can be worked on individually and strengthened accordingly to the qualities that you need to have for them to function in the way that they need to function. And that's not something that you can typically find at the gym. There are specific ways to do it, and I have covered that in previous videos. But anyways, qualities, it would be endurance, power, and recovery. So endurance, obviously you need to be able to stay in the fight. You got to be able to stay in the fight. You got to be able to continually put out. And you got to have the heart for it, too. Most of you guys are going to cut and run as soon as there's a hardship. Just kind of how it is. Because you guys don't have any standards. So anyways, power. You need to be able to, these are kind of joined together. You need to be able to pack a punch. So whether that's, you know, presenting your weapon with power, striking with your weapon, being able to display power when you take out your knife and engage somebody, being able to overpower somebody with power and manipulate them. It'll also have to be coupled with endurance, because doing that once isn't going to be enough. You're going to have to continually put out power, and that's where recovery comes in. This is one of the things that I see people diminishing the most is recovery. And what we're talking about is, for example, sprint training. So you go out and you conduct sprints all day. And the next day, what do people typically like to do? We recover. No. You need to be doing sprints again. That's recovery. You need to be, once you have done it and you have worn yourself out, you need to get up and do it again to form recovery, so your body gets adjusted to healing faster and working on that as well. And that also has to do with the mind, hormones. There's a lot that goes into recovery and being able to continually do things. And part of it, it's the heart and the mind. So you just got to keep that in mind. So the functions that you're going to be performing, and the reason why you need to have physical standards, is number one, if you're in a militia and things actually do go to hell, whether that's economics or whatever, you're probably not always going to have a ride somewhere. So you're probably going to have to work on your feet, and you might actually have to get all your crap and get somewhere in a short amount of time. Not unlike the military. So you need to be able to ruck it. So if it takes you 20 minutes to go a mile, you've got some work to do. You should be well under 15 minutes. That means that you're probably going to have to be running with that ruck at some point, or at least part of practicing fartlek training. And that's the best training that I found for actually getting recovery and stuff like that, and developing power and endurance, like all of this. Fartlek training is very good for that, but especially with a ruck. So Anyways, it's also technique. But fighting. So this is fighting in the form of combatives over subduing somebody, and also fighting in the sense of using cover and concealment and stuff like that, moving around and stuff, and being able to aim your weapon and present very fast, conduct reloads, all that crap. Anything to do with using a weapon and stuff like that, that's, you know, fighting. So even knives and stuff, so, and having all these qualities does help with that. So all these little things are going to demand all three of these qualities, by the way. So IMT, that's like your IADS, your immediate action drill. So for break contact, so the stuff that you'll do immediately if you get engaged and you have pre-planned actions and stuff, that's your IADS. So you'll have individual movement techniques that you'll need to follow. I'm up, he sees me, I'm down, or whatever, and you can train that very quickly. For training, I'm up, he sees me, I'm down, all you really need to do is put on more weight than you would actually carry. Maybe even use a ruck. This one weighs about 80 pounds. Start out with like 50 or 60 or something, or at least a third of your body weight, and conduct IADS. And you will sprint. You'll be sprinting with more weight, preferably twice the amount of weight that you'd usually use, and then recovering for half the amount of time. So say you're peeling out with a four-man team, and it usually takes about 5 seconds if you're doing a continuous peel for somebody to tap you on the shoulder and say, last man, after you have started engaging after your first movement. Well, let's go ahead and cut that in half, and you can individually practice that by peeling out, sprinting with your pack on, getting in a good firing position, and holding it for one Mississippi, two Mississippi, peeling out again. That is how you develop endurance, power, and recovery. Mostly the recovery portion and the endurance portion, but, you know, you'll still be working on power too. So, the next thing is patrolling. We're not talking about just moseying through the woods like the military does in the desert, because they don't really have to care, because they'll just drop air on somebody. But we're talking about ghosting this area. So wherever you're at, like if you're in the desert, you're kind of shit out of luck. But you know, if you have wood lines or something like that, then you need to work from cover to cover and actually learn to ghost walk or creep or sneak, you know, whatever you want to call it. You have to do it very slowly. That requires a lot of ankle stability, a lot of stability in legs and stuff like that. And you, in some cases, you're performing isometric holds in a squatted position because you're keeping a low profile. You're crouched the entire time. And you might even still have a ruck on, and you're navigating uneven terrain, probably going up hills and stuff, and you're trying to stay as quiet as possible and as coordinated while maintaining security. That is not a small task. So that's a quality that you need to work on, and you can't do that by doing the donut curl or going to the gym. See, this is what I'm talking about. You need to actually perform functional training that actually helps you with these functions. That's why it's called functional training. So it'll directly correlate to the skills that you need to develop. So, with all that said, that's the physical standards I would hold for people if I was starting militia. There's no excuses. You can always find time to condition yourself and to train your body in the movements, and then condition them for the hardship that they're going to need to endure. Develop these qualities. No excuses. But anyways, I appreciate you guys watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'll be doing some videos on how to work on these in the future. But anyways, hope it was fun. Hope you enjoyed it. You guys have a good one.